So I'm on the Gloucester Canal today. We're fishing Slimbridge at Patch Bridge. And because the water is very coloured, we're targeting skimmers and bream. Now, believe me, this canal is absolutely full of roach, but at the moment, they just don't feed them because of the colour. So therefore, we're looking to catch skimmers on the pole. As we're in spring and the clarity of the water, the roach aren't feeding. So therefore, I can get away with fishing pinkies for skimmers because you're not going to get bitted out. Now, I would either fish 2, 3, 4 pinkies on the pole on like a size 18 or size 20 hook. And it just stands out really well because they're fluorescent, they're very bright, visual, soft. Also, when I put them in the ground bait, I just tend to suffocate them. So I suffocate them for 3 days, just put them in a bag, wrap it up. So obviously they're not breathing and they're just stunned. So my theory is like vegetables. If you eat frozen vegetables compared to fresh, obviously fresh tastes a lot nicer. So that's my logic. So I literally just put suffocated pinkies into the ground bait and then pack the balls quite hard. Make sure it's quite a wet mix. Make sure it's like inert, if that's the correct way to say it. So therefore it's like much more dormant mix. So be quite positive and be patient and they will come. So when I target skimmers on the canal, what I do is I have two lines. I've got one at 11.5 meters and one at 14.5 meters. Now I put the 11.5 meter line directly in front of me and then the 14.5 meter, like about a 30 degree angle. So it's still comfortable when you fish. Don't want to be fishing like a 45 degree angle, which makes it more uncomfortable. Now the reason why I do that is because I have a bigger separation between the two lines. Because a lot of people will just cup in 4 balls of ground bait at 11 meters and then 4 balls of ground bait at 14.5 meters still in front of them. And I feel that's not a big enough separation distance. So you've got like two lines that are not going to conflict against each other. So to kick them off, I literally cup in 4 balls of ground bait at 11.5 meters, which is a 500 mil cup. So quite positive, not stupid. So 4 balls with a few dead pinkies in it, well, suffocated pinkies. And then exactly the same at 14.5 meters. And then what I do is I rotate between the two lines. Ideally sort of like catch a fish, maybe catch two fish, then feed it. So if you catch one, go in, don't catch, then top it up, then go on the other line, hopefully catch on that. And then you can get into a pattern then, and then it can be really, really productive way of catching. Oh, I've actually got one on. Happy days. So that's what I suggest doing. So just be nice and patient and hopefully you're gonna catch some fish like we've just, luckily enough, just caught one now. So just take your time, don't want to rush it, because the worst thing is if you lose it, what they're going to do is it's actually going to go back into the shoal and spook them, like sort of create like sort of like stress to the shoal, because they are shoal fish normally. So therefore just take your time. So what a lovely fish, a proper bream. So don't underestimate pinkies, give them a go.